Welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to New Year. We are going to react to our song. The Walker Brothers, Make It Easy On Yourself. This is our first time, absolutely first time, single take, honest reaction. Make It Easy On Yourself by the Walker Brothers. This is requested by our patron, Big Dan.
Yeah, it's our first time, single take, honest, unscripted, impromptu reaction coming your way. That's what we've been doing for more than 5 years on this platform. We're very happy to be here. Thanks to music. Thanks to you. Keep those requests coming on our Patreon page. Happy New Year to you. And let's get started.
Subscribe to the channel though, because...
Because what?
Because why watch without subscribing the channel? There is a button called subscribe, right?
Yeah, but music comes first to us.
It does.
Always, always music first. We won't beg for subscribers like so many others do. No.
Oh, breaking up is so very hard to do. If you really love him, and there's nothing I can do. Don't try to spare my feelings, just tell me that we're through. And make it easy on yourself. I hold you can't compare to his grace. No words of consolation will make me miss you less, my darling. If this is goodbye,
sound more like the Righteous Brothers in this one.
Righteous Brothers. Wow, nice orchestral
feel in the music. Lyrics are harping about one thing and one thing only. Make it easy on yourself, because breaking up is hard to do. Certainly is, certainly is. One of the things as a counselor, many times, so many articles I've read over the last 20, 25 years, so many e-books, I've also taught this subject for more than 15 years now to students, hundreds and hundreds of students from all over India and the world. And most common, one of the most common topics that of course comes up is breakups. You know, whether you like it or not, yeah, you have to take it up in the course as a major topic, because it's something that a lot of people go through at some time or the other in their life. Sometimes they are forced to go through it. Obviously, not all breakups are mutual. So one person is usually left high and dry. And, you know,
it's tough.
Many people even take their own life because of such reasons. Many people. In fact, one of the most common reasons for suicide in the world of today, whether it's in Japan or India or America, anywhere, one of the most common reasons is breakups. So, you know, it's a serious thing. It's a serious thing. So he's giving very nice, wise words. The Walker, the singer of this song, the Walker Brothers singer, that make it easy on yourself, because breaking up is hard to do. Yeah, so I fully agree with that line. And with him repeating it more than 12 times in a 3-minute song, yeah, I agree with it even more.
There was also a tinge of sarcasm because he's also going through the same kind of breakup, and he knows she is going to another person immediately. So he's saying, when you go, please run to him before you start crying. I'm gonna face that, but make it easy on yourself. Breakups, I don't get it. I seriously don't get it. If two people, either of the persons or even both, you know, it's kind of a trend, or it's an achievement or a bucket list of so many youngsters and even elderly people, I think. They are no less when it comes to relationships and being a nutcase in it. They think a breakup should be literally part of the bucket list that should be ticked, that I've had or I've had so many. It's nothing. It's no fun. It's not an activity. It's not a hobby. But it has, you know, the way media and the way the culture has evolved, especially the modern culture around the world, I would say, because it's all hodgepodge now, you know, being global. Good things spread slowly and bad things spread double the speed. Or maybe multiple times the speed of the good. So the one thing is, you know, people getting together. What were you thinking when you got together? If you didn't have any vision for it, when you didn't have any purpose for it, when you didn't have anything that you had in your mind, any, you know, aim for the relationship, why would you get into a relationship in the first place? And why are you breaking up then? Either you don't get into it, or if you are into it, have the courage to live by it. It's as simple as that. But yeah, these breakup songs and the breakup and breakup, it's so much of drama. I feel it's unnecessary drama created by people, and then so much misery ahead of it. But as a counselor, you can't really say that to people. So it's me personally saying that.
Yeah, and one other issue that comes with breakups is, I mean, there are millions of songs, I'm sure.
I know.
In different languages.
It's a heavily covered possibly topic in every possible in music language, and media and entertainment.
Whether you talk about Hindi, Marathi, Gujarati, English, French, Spanish, Portuguese, any possible language, I'm sure you'll have breakup songs and zillions of them. One thing I've noticed, I've heard my fair share of breakup songs, though I haven't been to too many breakups in my life. Thank
I
you.
Haven't had one breakup.
But the thing is that, you know, one of the things that I've noticed is that many breakup songs are made. And, you know, harping about how painful they feel and how sorrowful, how
it's
difficult
it is. It's a lot of attention-seeking thing.
How they feel after a breakup. That is the number one, possibly, topic that breakup songs are made on. You know, how difficult it is to move on without you and all that. Yeah, but not too many songs. And in fact, not too many articles also on the net. Not too much is written about how to move on after a breakup. And hence, it becomes so difficult. You know, for people around the world, that's why they need so much help of people like us, counselors, experienced counselors at that like us. They need our help so badly because they don't know where to go. You know, I mean, for me, whenever I went through my breakups earlier, it was long, long ago in my school days, college days. Whenever I went through it, most of the times I just moved on with my life, and perhaps that was the best medicine at that time. I moved on, I stayed busy with things. My hobbies would take center stage. In fact, the best poems I wrote, the best paintings I did were at such times. You know, so I really didn't have time to think about the impact of that breakup on my life. I just moved on with whatever I was doing at that time. So I often give the same advice. If I have to give advice as a counselor, I rarely do that. But if I do it, I always suggest move on with your life. Get busy with your normal things. If you aren't doing much in your life anyway, then take up hobbies. And definitely one of the things that you should do apart from being busy is meditation. So this is of course said by so many people now. When I used to say it 20, 25 years ago in my classes, and even in college days when I would write it in my answer papers that you should do this, you know, that time I wouldn't call it meditation as such. I would just say, just spend time with yourself in silence. So that time I would write it in my psychology papers, and I was a topper in my college, in my batch, I was a topper in psychology in LS Raja College. So I got a first class, which was very rare in those days for anyone to get a first class in that college for psychology. So, you know, after me getting it, a lot of other people ended up getting it, because I was one of the first, I think, that ever got a first class in the psychology 3 sociology thing. So anyway, the thing is that I always said the same thing, move on, be busy. So that's what my thing is, to make it easy on yourself, get busy and stay busy. So even when you're in love, it's not that you're totally dependent on that person. You know, that's the worst thing you can do to yourself and that person also. Be busy with your own life, do your own thing, and definitely it will be easier. Even if you have to move separate ways, or that person dies or you die, it will be easier on them to move on. That's it for this one. Check out our Patreon page to request reactions, which are totally impromptu, unscripted, single take like the one you just experienced with us. Mainly with me, of course. But Kirti, also listening to the song, that's good enough for most of you, I suppose. You know, an Indian woman sharing her perspective and taste with the rest of the world. How rare is that on this platform, which is so discriminatory that you'll hardly find someone like Kirti listening to Western music most of the time and giving her honest perspective on it. I say honest, not perspective. There are a lot of people giving their perspective on everything. But honesty, that's something missing in their perspective.